Hello everyone, welcome to the Power BI Simulator course. Today is our second lecture on how to create a case in Power BI Simulator. In this lecture, you will learn modeling of different power system components in PWS and how to use PWS for power system analysis and visualization. Here I am in the opening window of Power BI Simulator. To create a new case, click on the file button and click on the new case. It automatically opens the blank one-line page where I can place different power system components and create a power flow case. In Power BI Simulator, for different analysis, there are two modes of operation, the edit mode and run mode. The edit mode is used to add or edit object in power flow case, and run mode basically used for different type of analysis that we will perform in the Power BI Simulator. So now coming back to creating a new case. So whenever you will open a new case in PWS, the default mode will be the edit mode. That will be selected automatically. Here you can see. So in order to draw your case in PWS, simply go to draw button and go to the individual insert tab like in network. Here you can see that different objects are available. You can select these objects and place on the single line diagram. The first object need to be placed in the case is the bus. Here you can see that you can select the bus number in the bus dialog options, and the bus name, you can select bus name should be bus A. And similarly the voltage level 13.8 kV. So this is the display tab. In this you need to add the data of bus, like the bus number, bus name and the nominal voltage of the bus. And the bus should be, the orientation of bus should be right. We can select up so that the vertical bus will be placed. And similarly in shape, the bus shape should be rectangle or ellipse. So rectangle is fine. And also you can control the size of your bus also. So in the bus information tab, there is option of system slack bus. So in the complete case, there should be the one slack bus at least. And mostly the bus number one is a slack bus, but it's not a hard and fast rule. You can select different any other bus. First click on the system slack bus, and also in the bus voltage you can give these data also, the bus voltage and bus angle. But however, once you will solve your case, these information will be filled automatically, and click on OK. You can drag this bus name to the bus. And similarly place another bus, that is bus number 2, and the bus name should be the bus B, and the voltage of this bus is 138 kV. Sorry. And similarly the orientation should be up. Now in this bus information, no need to check this one, because at least there should be the one slack bus. Simply click on OK. Here you can see that the second bus is also placed on the one line diagram. And here you can see that the first bus voltage is 13.8 kV, the next bus voltage is 138 kV. So we cannot connect through a transmission lines with different bus voltage. So in order to connect these two buses, go to the transformer and click on the from bus to two bus, simply you need to add the series reactance like 0.001, and also you need to provide the rate A values, like this is 100 MVA transformer, and also I'm using the rough data, but in the upcoming cases we will use the calculated data. In the parameter tabs of transformer, you need to provide the resistance value, and normally the resistance is 0. And in the series reactance part, you need to provide the reactance, and similarly in the MVA limits, the rate A should be mentioned. And next tab in the transformer display tabs, you can select the different size and components and the shape of your transformer, and similarly the transformer control and all other tabs. So the transformer is applied, and next one is the generator. As we know that the generator is applied on a generator bus, so we have checked that bus to the slack bus. So we need to provide the megawatt input, like the 150 megawatt, the minimum megawatt is 0, and the maximum megawatt is like 250 megawatt. However, these values can be calculated from the generator capability curves, including megawatt information and the megawatt information. So we are not discussing any detail regarding the generator modeling. So we will do this discussion in the generator modeling of thermal, hydro, solar and the wind generator. So in this case, just we are introducing how to place different components and what type of data should we enter. So in the power flow and voltage control tab, the megawatt input and the megawatt out input should be added, and also you can provide the capability curve also. So these information can be directly taken from the capability curves of the generator. In the display information, that there is a one option like anchored, this option need to be checked, because whenever I will move a bus, then the generator will be moved with the that bus also. Here also in the shape, you can select the dog bone, and also you can fill your color and the select your color, like this one is green color, and click on OK. Here you can see the generator is applied, but the orientation is different. You can select on the generator information dialog, and in the display options you can select to the left, so that generation orientation will be fine. And these are the fields related to generator, the megawatt and megawatt. And similarly, you can place another bus of 132 kV, like the bus C, 138 kV, and the orientation is up. Now here you can see that the orientations are up, taken by default. Here is the third bus, and these, the bus B and the bus C, have same voltage level, so we can connect these two buses through a transmission line. Select the transmission line and click on any bus, and then go to the next bus, and then double click on that bus. Then the transmission line dialog options will be appear. Here you can add the RXP of transmission line, like R is 0 and the RX is 0.001, and the charging is 0 because we are assuming this is a short line, and the rating of this line is 1112 just for the links conductor. So we will discuss all these information regarding the modeling of transmission line, modeling of generators and the modeling of transformer in the upcoming lectures. So this is the basic introduction regarding the power system component modeling. And simply click on OK. So line is added, and the last one is the load on the bus C. As we know that the generator have megawatt capacity of 150 megawatt, and we can we can assume this megawatt value to 100 megawatt, and the megawatt value is like at 0.95 power factor, this is 50 megawatt. This is the constant power. And however, if you want to model the load in constant current and constant impedance also. So these two options are mostly we do in the dynamic stability analysis, but in power flow analysis, we model load as a constant power. And similarly, in the display options, you can select the orientation to right, and anchored button is checked, and click on OK. So this is the introduction regarding the power system component, how to place the different components on a single line diagram. So simply save your case and go to file and save case as. Yes. And similarly, you can select save your power world display also, because you need to save both files. The first one is the power world binary file that include the case information, and next one the power world display file. So in order to solve your case, simply go to run mode, shift and go to tools and click on the play button. Here you can see that the case is solved. So in order to see the information of power solution details, go to the case information, go to the model explorer and select the solution details. In solution details, you can import your Y bus matrix, Z bus matrix, but we are interested in here in mismatches. Here you can see that the megawatt mismatch and the megawatt mismatch is nearly zero. And go to tools, here you can see, coming back to the single line diagram, the case is working fine because there is no mismatch in the megawatt and megawatt. Why this 100 megawatt is changed from 150 megawatt to 100 megawatt? Because this is a slack bus. If this is not a slack bus, then that value will be fixed like the 150 megawatt. So here you can see that the case is properly converged and working fine. In order to stop the simulation, click on the stop button. So now simulation is paused. So this is the end of our today's lecture. Thank you for joining us. See you in the next lecture.